Hi, today I want to show you how to make this little ornament using the circular sewing attachment on the Janome MC9450. Hi, I'm Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Before we get started into this little project today, if you're not already a subscriber to my YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe now and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. Today, we're going to be working with the circular sewing attachment, and this particular one for the Janome MC9450 says that it is for easy set bobbin models, and I'll put the part number in the description below the video so you know exactly which one it is. And it looks like this, and it comes with a little set screw in it. So it's really important to get the right part number so that you know what's going to fit your model. If you have a model that's different than the 9450, it might be a different part number, so make sure you're very careful about that. One thing you'll notice when you get the circular sewing attachment is included in the package is this cardboard instruction, little packet sort of. So don't throw it away. Make sure you open it up and it tells you how to attach it and how to use it and everything. So you want to make sure you keep this because it's quite important. Okay, let's actually put it on the machine now. Now, you're going to need your screwdriver that came with the machine in order to install the circular sewing attachment because you've got that little set screw that's going to go into this part of it, and it's going to go into this little hole over here. You'll see it all just fits in perfectly when you put it in, but I just want to point out a couple of things with this little attachment first. You'll notice that there's a little part that sticks up here. When you push it down, that allows you to move part of it along, and depending on where you have this part here, that'll determine the size of your circle. And you'll see what I mean when I actually put some fabric on it. But you want to lock that, of course, before you start stitching. So to do it, it's very easy. Just push up on the bottom part. So push down to move, push up to lock. There's also this black part here, and this actually comes off. It's just a cap, it's just a cover. And there's a very, very sharp little piece here. It's like a little tack almost. And that's going to go through your fabric, come out the top, and then you're going to put the cap on, and that's going to keep the fabric attached to the circular sewing attachment. So we're going to look at that closer when we actually go stitch with it, but let's figure out how to put it on now. So you need to take off your bobbin cover, take that off, put it aside, and then you're going to attach your circular sewing attachment. Now, to keep things out of the way, I'm going to move this part way over to the edge here as far as I can, and then you can see this part here goes in and replaces the bobbin cover. So it just fits in there. No connections or anything, it just kind of fits in, just like your bobbin cover would do, except there's no prongs on it or anything. And then this is why you need the little screw. It's going to go in there, and you're gonna screw that down, and then you wanna make sure you use your screwdriver to tighten it up. Okay, so you can use your hand as far as you wanna go with that, but you definitely wanna tighten it up with that screwdriver because you don't want it coming off, so make sure it's nice and tight, it's not moving at all. Okay. So that's part one, you've got it attached. The next thing I need to do is to get my sandwich all ready to go. So I've got my fabric, I've got batting, just 100% cotton batting, and I've got a lightweight tearaway stabilizer behind here. If you're not familiar with using stabilizer with decorative stitches, there's a video I have done on that and I'll put a link to it so you can take a look at that. The next thing you want to do is attach this sandwich onto the circular sewing attachment. So we're going to remove the cover, and don't put it too far away because you're going to need it in a minute. And I'm going to put my fabric, the whole sandwich really, on top of that little pin in the middle. Be very careful when you're attaching it because, like I said, it's very sharp. Okay, and I'm putting it approximately in the middle of my sandwich here. You can mark where you want it to go if you do want to do that. I find it easier to start off with a bigger piece of fabric then I want to end up with, and I'll just trim it later. That way I don't have to really fuss about making sure that I get this in exactly the center of that fabric. Now I want to move my little part over there. I'm not sure what you call that part exactly, but basically you're moving the whole attachment along there and lock it off. And I am working with the smallest circle I can make with this one. I've got my little adjustment piece here, my locking mechanism over as far as I can. I've got it locked down, ready to go. Now, I have already preset up my decorative stitches that I want to use. I always suggest when you're working with them to do your decorative stitches on a practice sandwich first, so you can adjust the stitch length or width if you want to. And In this particular case, I have adjusted the stitch width and length on some of these stitches, and I've saved those as favorite stitches. Now, if you don't know how to do that on your Janome MC9450, I've done a separate video to show you how to do that, and I'll put a link to that so you can learn how to do that as well. The next thing I want to do when I'm working with this first line of decorative stitches is I want to make sure it's going to all lay on my fabric. So I'm going to just move around here and see, I know it's all going to be on there. But you know what I'm thinking? As I build this out with more circles, it may be a little close to the edge on especially this side here. So I think I'm going to adjust. So this is some of the stuff you might have to do here. No worries if you have to. Pretty simple. Move your little piece out, unlock it, move it out. Take your fabric off. I'm just going to move this down a little further. There, I know that's going to work really well. Put my cap back on. There we go. So it's just locked on. Let's move back again. And let's lock ourselves in place. There we go. So I know that gives me lots of room all the way around. I'm using a variegated thread here too, because it looks quite nice with this, these stitches I've chosen. Actually, you can use any thread you want. I'm also using my F2 foot. So this gives me an open view. I can see how my threads are working, how my decorative stitch is going along. I'm starting off with a decorative stitch. A satin stitch is actually what I'm going to start working with at first. Go back and find my satin stitch here. I'm working with S10, and as I say, I have already changed the width, the length of it, I guess, actually, the width as well. Actually, I've changed on this particular one, and I've locked it in as a favorite stitch. So we are just going to start going. I'm going to hold my thread, bring my bottom thread up. Okay, make sure it's up there. Before we start, I want to make sure that my presser foot's going to come up when I stop sewing. And by the way, when you're working with this, adjust your speed. It doesn't have to be really, really fast. You don't want to be doing these super fast. So as I'm working along here, I've got all these pieces of fabric and stabilizer and batting that are going along. I want to make sure that it doesn't catch on anything. You've got this little set screw here. It might catch on that, or as it comes around, it might catch on things. So every so often, I'm making sure I'm just smoothing with my hands and keeping this up a little bit just so it doesn't get caught. Because if it gets caught, things start to ball up with your stitches. So now I'm going to put the next row of stitching in. So I want to see where it's going to fall before I actually lock in the circular sewing attachment. So it actually is going from the left to the right. So I want to put it close. Now I want to make sure it's not inside the other circle. I want to make sure it's outside a little bit. So I'm going to actually use my hand wheel to drop my needle. So that looks like it's outside the first circle I stitched. That looks good. So now that I've dropped my needle in, I can lock up. Remember, I just pressed the mechanism up there and it's going to lock it in, and then I'm ready to start. And so you always want to stop and take a look and see how it's doing, make sure it's falling where I want it to, because if it's not, I could stop at this time, take my stitches out, change where I've got my circle set up here to go and start over again. But you don't want to go all the way around and go, oh, I don't like how it looks. So stop and make sure everything's going the way you want it to, and then continue on. Okay, so this is my last one that I'm doing. I want to make sure I'm out far enough. This one actually is starting sort of in the center and it's moving in a bit, so I want to make sure I'm over far enough that it's not going to cause me any problems when it starts stitching and goes in. Okay, I've got all three circles done now. I can remove it from the circular sewing attachment, make sure I put that cap back on. I'm gonna move it over to the side here and lock it up so it shouldn't move any further. So this is what we have now. So the next step in this process would be to take off the tearaway stabilizer so it just tears. And it'll just come off. You can take that off in the interior and as much as you can get off between the layers in here. Because it's an ornament, I wouldn't fuss too much. If you can't get these off, these little bits here, I wouldn't worry about them. Take off the center one and you can see how easily it tore off there. And then the next thing you need to do with this is you need to trim it up to the size you want. The case of the one I used here, I used it, it's actually 5 inches unfinished, so it's about 4.5 now. So you can just cut that up. Make sure you use this as the center, right, and go out from either side. So 2.5 inches out one side, 2.5 inches out the other side, top and bottom, same thing. Trim it all up. You're also going to need to have a backing. So I have a piece of fabric, same thing. You're going to want this to be 5 inches all the way around. And then you also want to have a little hanging loop, right? So you just need to cut a little piece of that. See how long you want it. So you just fold it in half. It's going to be tucked into the top here. So just, it doesn't need to be in very far, maybe 1/2 inch or something like that. So just figure out what you think is the appropriate length for depending on where you want to hang it and what you want to hang it on. And you're going to put that together and you're going to use the pillowcase method to put this all together. And if you don't know how to do that, I will put a link into a previous video I have on how to do the pillowcase method. And that's what you're going to do. And then when you've got it all together, there's one extra little thing. There's a button in the center of it. And how do you put that button in? Well, I actually used my Janome 9450 to put the button in. And I will show you how to do that in another video. So I put a link to that too, because it made it really easy. I didn't have to thread a needle or do anything. Machine sewed it all on for me. So you can see that video too to show you how to do that. And by the way, I kind of cheated a little bit. When I put this together on the side here, you'll have that open side that you need to finish off. I actually just used a glue stick. I just opened it up, put some glue in, made sure the raw edges were folded in, and I actually pressed it down with my iron, and that works really well. So I've got this little ornament all ready to go. Okay. I hope you enjoyed creating this little ornament using the Janome MC9450 and the circular sewing attachment. I also wanted to let you know that the button I've used in here is found at Incomparable Buttons, so you can find them online. I'll put a link in the description below so you can look at all the wonderful buttons they have. If you liked this video, and I hope you did, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And if you're interested in joining a group of fun quilters online, consider joining The Quilter's Way. It's my online membership group, and you can find out all about it at thequiltersway.com.